In New Zealand, Lance Stroll.
Yes.
Lance Stroll, he won. So
oh, Canada.
There we go. Yeah, so Lance Stroll, I've been talking about this kid. I've been actually following his career for a long time. We have been. And this so far this year, the first part of this year, I guess, up until now, he's been taking part of the New Zealand Toyota Racing Series. Mm. And they race on cars much like this. Well, actually, this is his car, obviously.
Much like F1.
Yeah, much like F1. I mean, they're single seaters, and like, but you can tell some of the elements. These are proper race cars. Mm-hmm. They're nowhere near the technical level of F1, but you can see some elements for sure. So it's a proper single seater racing series. And Lance Stroll, our boy from Canada, he is the champion.
The champion.
He won.
And he won the last race too.
Yeah, he won the last race.
Fuck.
Closed out the season in style.
Yeah.
Good for him.
And actually, that last race that he won is called the New Zealand Grand Prix. Now, this goes back, I'm sure I've told you guys before, before F1, there used to be these competitions called Grand Prix, a national Grand Prix. It used to be like the highest motor racing like race,
right,
of each country.
Right.
And actually, the FIA right now only recognizes races that are called Grand Prix as being the ones in the F1 calendar, except for two. The Macau Grand Prix and the New Zealand Grand Prix. So this is a proper New Zealand Grand Prix recognized by the FIA. And our boy Lance Stroll, he won the race, and he is a champion.
Congratulations.
Yeah,
and congrats, mate.
Mr. Stroll. this kid is actually going places, and other than the obvious like a factor that he has
tons
of money, and he does seem to be a pretty good driver all in all. You know, it's not like
I would say so.
Well, yeah, he's not like a Max Chilton that, you know, got mediocre results and still made it to F1. He's clearly doing something right. He's in the Ferrari Driver Academy. Mm. He's one of the youngest there, or one of the youngest that got signed for it.
Dad's got money to push him.
Yeah, his dad's got billions to push him.
It's kind of necessary these days.
Yeah. Well, but it's just one of the things that the intricacies of the sport right now. And after this, he's going to race in the European Formula 3 Series,
right,
for the Prema team. And now, European Formula 3, that's where Max Verstappen came from. Max Verstappen, he was European Formula 3 last year. Now, this year, he's in F1.
Unfortunately, so he kind of ruined the whole points requirement age type thing for this dude.
Thanks, Verstappen. Yeah, so this Verstappen kid got signed for a professional Formula 1 team.
Yeah.
And then, he's 17. He's going to be racing next year. He's 17. Yeah. And shortly after it was announced, The head honchos of F1 basically were like, no, this cannot happen again. Minimum entry age of 18.
No more children, must be 18 years old.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
And there is the point requirements needed from your previous experience to get it, your super license.
Anyway, but so, I think he's on the right track.
Also affects him, probably.
Yeah, it probably does. But
this championship helps him for sure.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think he needs to win F3 next year
to get enough points.
To get enough points to get a super license to be considered for F1.
Well, he's probably, what's probably going to happen is that he's in Prema doing Formula 3, right? He has 2 years that he knows he can be in F1. They're probably going to want, for the Ferrari Driving Academy, has got him on actually. He's participating on two major competitions, this New Zealand one that he just won, and then the rest of the year he's basically going to be around Europe racing Formula 3. So that's this year.
Do you know what team he's racing for?
Prema.
Prema?
It's called Prema Powered. Prema team or something. It's an Italian-based team, which is very fitting because his association with Ferrari.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Then I'm sure that next year, because he still can't go into F1, Ferrari will probably find a way to keep him busy with GP2 or something, honing his racecraft. But one of the things that was very interesting is that at the very beginning of the season of this racing series in New Zealand, he basically dominated everything, and actually he finished with 108 points ahead of his closest competitor. So people are calling him Mr. Consistency. Like that's what they were calling it, referring him to in New Zealand. So and that is Jeez. One of yeah, that is one this, of the attributes.
Is this his thing? He's like Vettel, but he's got his finger turned the other way.
I guess
Vettel,
like,
Vettel does this one. He's got this.
Maybe he's trying to start something. But I think that that's something very very good for an F1 driver, because we have some drivers that can be brilliant, can be magnificent, and will pull off some fantastic performances, but just not all the time. Mm. If you're there, if you're a reliable driver, then that you can be counted on to extract as much of the car as right. possible, okay. time and time again.
Right.
That may be priced even higher than having one or two hot laps that broke a record. You know what I mean?
It's great for him, but one big difference between this and Formula One is that I'm sure these cars don't have as many mechanical problems or...
Well,
they're not as much probably luck factored in or like...
Oh, well, everybody's racing with basically the same car pretty
much.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
It's almost like a spec series.
Good for him, though. Good for him.
Well, honestly, I guess that makes it more impressive, because if everybody's got the same equipment...
Right.
He's destroying them in their own car.
Yeah, yeah. Right. Yeah,
say like, oh, your car was so much better. It never broke down.
Exactly.
Nothing to do with the car.
Yeah. It's all about his maple syrup that I'm sure he's consuming every day for breakfast.